Okay, I'm kind of pissed off. I went on the Mattel Creations website and I found out what was supposed to go behind the bush. My box, for some reason, someone stole the Tyrannosaur Paddock sign out of mine before it got shipped. 'Cause you saw it, it was in a Mattel box, it was sealed. They somehow stole the sign out of the box. It's not in there. I've looked again. Just missing, just gone. Doesn't that just fucking piss you off? And I paid $80 for this box set. I'm gonna have to write to Mattel, send them this video, see if they can do anything, which I highly doubt. Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Last time I had filmed any Hammond collection was about 6 or 8 months ago. I think it was 6 months ago. Anyway, since then, back in September, my Jurassic World Hammond Collection Outhouse Chaos set came. And then I had dental surgery and several stints of stitches in my mouth and being swollen and sore and not able to talk. But basically, today, I'm finally gonna open my Outhouse Chaos set. This was a Mattel Creations, was it San Diego Comic-Con last year? I don't know if it was for that, but it was definitely Mattel Creations, and it was a limited edition, and, well, let's just get it open, and we'll talk some more about it. I don't know if this bodes well for Gennaro. I was getting the box out, and this fell out of one of the flaps. So hopefully it's not ruined to the point where you need to order another one because there aren't more. Presentation though, like, check out that box. If I put this box somewhere and put my Jeep in front of it, holy moly, that's pretty. Look at that. Oh yeah. Okay, so probably keep in the box. Not gonna keep it in the box, but I'm probably keeping the box. Okay, right off the bat, the corner is dinged up. The inside has come unglued, and I appear to have a broken. No, I don't know. Is this a repack? This came right out of the box like this. Direct from Mattel. You saw the shipping box. This is how it came. If I was an in-box collector, how pissed would I be? This is atrocious. What in the world happened to this? Hopefully everything's still in here. Like this. This whole thing was in the other box, and this fell out. But hopefully I'm not missing anything. I mean, if this wasn't all screwed up, that's gorgeous. Like the box design with the little window and the Rex displayed like that. Beautiful. But it looks like the Rex has already eaten Gennaro. And it's not. It's sealed. Look at that. Should I continue opening it even? Or should I send it back? During the trial run of Jurassic Park, Donald Gennaro ends up courting disaster when he frantically flees from his vehicle in hopes of hiding from the Tyrannosaurus Rex. However, he learns the true meaning of when nature calls during this bathroom breakdown where his objection is clearly overruled. That's what this little blurb says. Gorgeous. Gorgeous box. It is slightly damaged on the corner. That's what I was trying to say when I noticed everything chaos inside. It is Outhouse Chaos, after all. So, it's a good thing I am not an in-box collector. Can you believe that? Still sealed. Like, here's the tape. Sealed, sealed, sealed. direct shipped from Mattel. The tape is not broken. You can see it right there. Not broken there either. What in the world? Decisions. Okay, well, I'm not an inbox collector. I didn't watch anyone else's reviews because I didn't want it spoiled for me. Did everyone have this problem? Let me know in the comments below if you had chaos inside your box before you even opened it. Because I'm speechless. I don't know what to say. All right. Is it supposed to be? I guess that's a try me spot. Because it doesn't look broken. It is scuffed to all hell. There's a nice big gash right here in the plastic. I don't know if you can see it or not. Can't really zoom you in too much more than this. But you can see here's a scratch right here. And then this mark right here. Can you see that? I want you to be able to see it. There it is. It's like a, I don't know, like it's been. And here's the thing that the briefcase was in. Looks like he's supposed to have a hat too. Hopefully I can find the hat. Did it just come unglued? Maybe it just came unglued. Because it sat for so long. That's just. Boy. I hope it just came unglued. And that not everyone had this problem. That sucks, though. It really does. Alright. So I haven't cut, and I'm just going to go ahead and film myself opening this. So we can see there's a scratch here, there's a scratch here. Cutting the tape for the very first time. Now you can see there's a gap there. I can take a Gennaro out. I can take the toilet out. No sign of the hat. I think I hear it in there, though. I'm half tempted to just leave the. Okay, there's tape here. You can tell that this has never been opened. I'm half tempted to leave the box, or leave the Rex in the box so it displays nice. Because I don't really have a display for Gennaro. Other than I could put him in a Jeep, I guess. Would be nice to make sure I have the hat, though. Let's see, did I find it? Aha! The hat. Okay, so we have a briefcase or a satchel. We have a hat. We have the bit that they were supposed to be in. We have Gennaro and his toilet. And the Rex. Will she slide out just like this? Ah, she will. No going back now. Well, I could literally just slide her back in, but I want to get her out and look at her, because I want to see if her paint job's any better than the other one, to be honest. Because the other Hammond Rex is kind of a joke. I lifted it out just like that. The outer box fell off. It is no more damaged than it already was. It's really pretty. Ow. Hit my knee on the desk. I'm going to leave that in, too. Anybody want to rent me a studio? Jesus. Okay. We have some bamboo. Oh, I bet this was supposed to go around here. I guess it goes around the potty. Yeah. Yep. I could see that getting messed up real easy if you weren't careful. And there's Gennaro. Put the stuff back around the potty. It doesn't seem to be bent or damaged, which is nice. We have some instructions here for assembly and battery operation of our Rex. Okay, the Rex doesn't have a battery. The potty has a battery. And also, here we have, this is the important part. Taped in the bottom here, we have the cardboard outhouse to build around the toilet. So that's still in here. The toilet works. I've heard it a few times now. And I heard it before I even opened the box, which makes sense now if it was rattling around in there. In terms of reviewing it, I think we're good to go. Give me a second to rearrange this mess. All right, decision time. I am going to do something that I never do. And I'm going to leave this Rex in the box. Just like that. I might cut the tail out of the box and put it somewhere else, like in the bottom of the box or something, because it's getting bent. You see the tip right up in here is getting bent against the box. But the reason is because this is my other Hammond Collection Rex. And as you can tell, this one's joints are getting loose because I had it up like this and it sat there for a minute or two. And then just, whoop. So this one is getting loose, doesn't display well, falls over a lot. And if I leave this one in the box, not only is it, in my opinion, a better looking Rex, it's colored appropriately for the scene, it doesn't have this sinking feeling. I don't know if you can see her moving like a possessed toy. But I have set up over here, I will try to show you when I get it reset up. I have the scene with the explorers and the rain and the Rex and the attack, the road attack scene, is on display in my office. So I think what I will do is I will take the Rex out of that and replace it with this Rex in the box with Gennaro in the outhouse. And then put the other Rex away and leave this better looking, quote unquote, better looking Rex on display. Because the box is just so frickin' stunning. I can't stand it. There she goes. Like a worn out, like a damp animatronic. But that gives you a good look at the paint differences. You can see she's got more of a warm tone on her paint job. And this other one painted with the nighttime scheme has more of a greenish, darker tone. Still has this weird brown lip mustache thing going on. Still has... Well, I think that one at least has round pupils, which is nice. But since it's the same Rex, same construction, same everything, my fear is that it's going to end up like this one and won't be able to stand up over time. If I leave it strapped in the box, it'll just be that way, on display. It'll be clean, there won't be any dust on it because the box will protect it. And hopefully the shelf wear will be kept to a minimum. Sound like a plan to you? Sounds like a plan to me. So anyway, other than that, exactly the same Hammond Collection Rex as this other one. Just a little bit slightly different paint, slightly better paint. And the eyes look better. Maybe they're just more clear. Maybe it's the angle. Not sure on that one, but this one always, the eyes didn't look like they had round enough pupils for me when I first opened it up. So that's the Rex. That's the Rex part. All right, ladies and gentlemen, this is Donald Gennaro. He can wear his hat just fine. I'm not sure it would stay on. He can carry his briefcase in his hand. But this is how we'd like to see him, right? Sitting on the toilet. He doesn't sit on the toilet. He has little foot pegs, and once you put his feet on the feet pegs, he more like, I don't know, hover pees? Hover poops? But they did a nice job on the figure and the face. He's got his tie on. His tie has nice texture. It looks like he's supposed to. I can tell who it is. And of course, when you push the button, you get sound. And lightning. There's the elephant lion roar that we're used to. Not sure how many sounds it's supposed to play, but I think it plays three different ones. Now that we've seen how the outhouse base works, and the toilet, and the sounds and lights, I'm going to go ahead and build the cardboard surround so it's a full outhouse and we can see what it looks like all put together. I just want you to know this, because it's really easy to screw this up. It has pre-marked bend points. You can see mine's got a little bit of a weird bend right here. It's because it tried to not bend on the seam. There's one here pre-marked. And the other one is where they glued it together on the back, so that tends to naturally want to fold there. So if you're doing this, start with this seam, not the glued together one, because this one is the one that wants to bend the wrong way. And basically, once that is bent, they pre-cut the door for you. They've scored the door hinge. Make sure you bend that carefully or you don't screw it up. But that is the box that surrounds the outhouse. And you can leave that other piece in there, the broken piece, because it has little tabs on the outside. This slides over the entire thing. So you can see inside he still has the bamboo surround around the bottom of the toilet. So if you have the Rex pull it off, it'll look like a broken outhouse. As if you're gonna let your kid play with this. I would not. No way. That is how cardboard toys get ruined. Now, the little plastic tabs along the bottom seem to not actually hold this very well. It doesn't slide in all the way. It just holds it just barely, so it's up against the base. You can't go down any further than the button in the front will let you go. So it doesn't go down all the way. You can see there's some brown along the bottom edge all the way around. And it will also come off quite easily. That makes my heart happy, because if I wanted to film the inside of the toilet scene, it would have the lightning like it did in the film. I am just not a normal person. This is one of the best days of my life. Okay, this doesn't seem to have any specific direction. This roof just slides on very carefully. I decided to put the seam in the back left of the outhouse so I can display it like this without the seams on the roof. I can put Gennaro in his potty. May have to display him outside of the box or untie the Rex's head because they don't want to both fit in there. Display problems. I don't want to untie the Rex because she's gonna fall over. I do want to fix her arm though. Arm looks a little goofy. That's probably how I'm gonna have to display it. Just like that. Then I'll put it back in its little original box. You'll be able to see Gennaro if you look in the front. And Rex is displayed, trying to eat him. And the outhouse. You can see I took the tail out. Its first bend was bendy, so I was able to straighten it out. Its second bend is just the rubber, so I'm going to have to let it relax. Maybe have to lay it flat like that for a while just to let it relax. But then I'm going to store it flat, maybe in the box. Like so. Yeah, that'll actually work. That way, if I ever take her out and want to assemble her, I can, but her tail won't have that weird kink in the end from being in the box for 20 years. We're good to go. And there's little accessories. Not sure where they were supposed to be attached originally. There is a little plastic something back behind this bush inside the box, but they don't fit there necessarily or at all. I'm not sure what that was supposed to be. But yeah, let me go ahead and put this back in the box like I'm going to display it. And we'll go from there. I'm still hoping for another release of Gennaro so he can be in the Jeep or whatever with the kids. Or in the Explorer. Explorer with the kids, Jeep with Hammond is what it would be, but I don't think we have a Jeep 29 yet. I'd have to make one. Mattel, what are you slacking? Anyway, give me a second, and then we'll do final thoughts in a minute. Well, there it is. That's pretty much how I'm going to display it on my shelf. Since I have this end open, that was very clever of me, because now if I want to take the outhouse out and take a picture with it or anything, all I have to do is open that end of the box, take it out, do the thing, and then put it back, and that's perfect. A little bit of a shorter video because we didn't assemble our Rex and take a closer look at it, but again, it is exactly the same as the previous Hammond Collection Rex, with the exception of the tone of the paint color. And of course, Gennaro, standard action figure, assembled, articulated exactly the same way all the others are. Looks like Gennaro. They did a nice job on it. So, not too many complaints other than the packing fiasco. I still can't get over that. That was a wild chaos in the box before I even get it open. Some minor corner damage on the box. I'm not usually a box collector, so that doesn't really, you know, that doesn't ruin it for me, but it would be nicer if it wouldn't have come damaged. And hopefully if you're an inbox collector and you like things to be mint, yours had a better trip than mine did. Again, I know this is a little bit of an older set. This came last September from Mattel Creations. On the secondary market now, I'm not sure what it's going for, but if you were able to get one, let me know what you think about it in the comments below. And if you had the same packaging problems as I did, let me know how your Hammond Rex is holding up, if you have one that's assembled and out of the box. Because, as you saw in this video, my other one is a little bit loosey-goosey. Great box art. Nice design. Love the outhouse play features. Yeah, nothing really terrible to say about it. And it does, thankfully, say Jurassic Park, and have the Jurassic Park gates and the Jurassic Park logo all over it instead of Jurassic World. We've got some more Hammond collection coming up. We'll be posting all of Jurassic June, so stay tuned for that. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you have, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. That would mean a great deal to me, and I really do appreciate everybody's support. Until next time, happy hunting. Okay, I'm kind of pissed off. I went on the Mattel Creations website, and I found out what was supposed to go behind the bush. My box, for some reason, someone stole the Tyrannosaur Paddock sign out of mine before it got shipped. Because you saw it, it was in a Mattel box, it was sealed. They somehow stole the sign out of the box. It's not in there. I've looked again. Just missing. Just gone. Doesn't that just f***ing piss you off? And I paid $80 for this box set. I'm gonna have to write to Mattel, send them this video, see if they can do anything, which I highly doubt. But that just sucks. That absolutely sucks. I don't know what else to say. Was a great day, was a great toy. Came banged up, and someone stole the sign out of it. Nice job, kids. Way to go. Jesus.